Hello, I'm MS and let's do some soldering! I always wanted to create my own PCB board, so I designed it, I ordered it, and now it's arrived, so let's do it! Danger, danger, noobies there. Of course, I've messed up something with voice. So, basically I decided to not order PCB stencil because it was too expensive. I tried to 3D print one on my 3D printer. I use 0.15mm nozzle. Let's check it under the microscope. And looks like everything is fine. Maybe this little one is a little bit clogged, but we will fix it later. Tiny ones looks good. Same for audio chip. 2040 cores are the hardest part. Their parts are really tiny, but everything looks good. And the rest of board also it's fine. Let's try to put it on the board. And the alignment is also fine, so time for soldering paste. I'm doing some soldering and happy humor have components align itself because it's solder paste. Great, the board is now soldered, but I messed up and I ordered the wrong LDOs. The model was fine, but the package was different, so I was not able to mount it. And a lot of short circuits, so next stencil will be thinner. New LDOs chips arrived. Let's try it out. Time I had a lot of issues with cleaning up the board from the flux. So let's try the new tissues. The white one is totally mess, it's leaving a lot of small threads, but the green one is perfect.
No, God! No, God, please, no! No! No!
Time for test if we have short circuits on power lines, so let's check the bus regulators. It looks fine. Also let's check our MCU regulators, and those also looks fine. And the last one is plus 5 volt for USB. Alright, let's connect power supplies and keep finger crossed. And it's time to check voltages. 3 plus 3 volt bus. It should be disabled because it's controlled by salt bridge. Same for 3.3 volt for bus. MCU power supply is also disabled. But the south bus is constant 3.3 volts, so everything looks fine. And 5 volts for USB. Those tiny little ones try to escape, and of course the values are mixed, so have fun! The board is now connected to debug port of Pico Probe and also to serial port. And now it's time to verify if the board is working at all or not. I've checked the board out of the recording and I've realized that RP2040 core is not properly soldered, so I've resoldered it again and after that let's check out, maybe now it's working.
Oh yeah!
Let's try some real example from Pico SDK official examples. I've realized that flash memory is not working properly, so let's try with execution from RAM. To achieve it, we have to modify the project a little bit. Of course, I messed up name. Of course, with monitor reset init command, I removed application that I previously loaded with load, so it's not going to be working. Let's try out one more, and still is nothing. Finally, after hours of fight, the board is working. Off screen I've checked what's going on with that flash memory that can be programmed, and it was yet another problem with soldering. The QSPI pins wasn't soldered properly, so I've put more solder paste there and now everything is working fine. In next episode I'm going to show you the hardware design and hardware overview about this board and parts that I'm going to using in the next few episodes. I'm not professional PCB designer, so please keep in mind that not everything that I showed is created in the best way. Also, this project is created just for fun and for learning stuff, so I'm not giving any warranty or liability. The full board is created as on open hardware stuff, so you can find it on my GitHub. The links are under the video, so if you are interested, don't be afraid to check it. Thanks for watching and see you soon!